This lesson is an example of using an EJB, an Enterprise Java Bean, in a JSP page with a tag that you haven't seen before. This tag identifies the bean. It gives it an ID. The ID is the name by which it will be referred in this page. It also specifies the name of a Java class. This is the class file of the bean. The simplest definition of a bean is a class that has a default constructor, so it can be created without parameters being passed to it, and it has one or more methods that begin with the words get and put. Now, this is the date class of the standard Java API, and it qualifies as a bean because it has a default constructor. When you construct an object without an argument, it assumes the current date and time. It also has a method named getTime, which can be used to return the current number of milliseconds since January 1, 1970. Here you see the getTime method being called and the return value being used in a test. That is, it's used in a Boolean expression that results in true because it does not equal zero. This test is an attribute of the if tag, and if it's true, the body of the tag is executed and made part of the page. If it's false, the body is skipped. Here, the value of the time is output to the page instead of being used in a test. The output is a numeric value, but being included as part of a Java string, it's automatically converted to a string and made part of the display. Now, getting the data from a bean is really a matter of syntax. Here's what happens explicitly in the statements above. Each time you refer to the get method, a new object of the class is created this way, and a call is made to the getTime method. This also works just as well as the other and is probably a bit more flexible because you can call any method of the bean, not just the get methods. It's really just a matter of personal preference. You can do it any way you wish and get the same result. You can put either style inside of a test block. And here's the result. Notice that the two count values are not the same. That's because each one is a new instance of the class, and a new time value is created for each one, and they're just a few milliseconds apart. You can write your own Java classes and use these same truncated and untruncated syntax forms in its methods. I'll be showing you that in the next lesson.